artificial intelligence is becoming increasingly ubiquitous. But if you are looking to make money using AI on the stock market, it may be prudent to think carefully before jumping on the AI bandwagon. That's one lesson you can take away from a new study conducted by the Chinese University of Hong Kong, which looked at the success rate of machine learning in generating stock picking returns. The researchers analyzed a large sample of U.S. stocks between 1987 and 2017 using three well-established deep learning methods. Using these algorithms, they were able to generate a decent monthly return of up to 0.75% to 1.87% after adjusting for common risk factors. However, this performance would attenuate when the algorithms were limited to cheap and easy to trade stocks. It fell 62% when the shares of smaller and illiquid stocks or microcaps were excluded, 68% when firms that were not tracked by debt rating agencies were excluded, and 80% when excluding distressed firms associated with credit rating downgrades. It also found that machine learning-based trading strategies typically incurred high transaction costs. To eke out any returns, they typically relied on high turnover and taking extreme stock positions, and they would struggle to achieve meaningful alpha after taking transaction costs into account. Nevertheless, machine learning-based strategies can sometimes be profitable. The study found that during several major market downturns, the best machine learning investment method generated a monthly value-weighted return of 3.56%, even when excluding microcaps, compared with a market return of negative 6.91% during the same periods. The researchers also say, while the profitability of trading strategies based on shorting stock anomalies has fallen in recent years, machine learning-based strategies are more profitable in long positions and are likely to remain viable going forward, making them particularly valuable for real-time trading, risk management, and long-only institutions. Read the article by China Business Knowledge at CUHK to find out more about the research.